To thee we come, O Lord our God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We will go unto the altar of God. Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. My dear brothers and sisters, let us confess our sins to God and prepare ourselves that we may worthily participate in this holy sacrifice. And now please make an examination of your conscience. For your penance, I ask that for the next 3 nights, you take one of the 3 readings as prescribed by the Church for this Sunday in the Octave of Corpus Christi, and also repair any injury that you may have done unto others. And now let us recite together the second act of confession. I confess to Almighty God, one in the Holy Trinity, in the presence of the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, and saint in thought, word, and deed, by my own great fault, I ask the Blessed Mother Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy upon us, forgive us our sins, and bring us unto life everlasting. May the Almighty and Merciful Lord grant us pardon, absolution, and remission of all our sins.
Amen.
May our Lord Jesus Christ absolve you, and with his authority vested in me by him, I absolve you of your sins. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O God, you will again renew us.
Amen.
Show us your mercy, Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
And let our cry be to you.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Take our sins away from us, Lord, so that we might enter the Holy of Holies with purified hearts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, you nourish your people with food of angels and furnish them bread from heaven, ready to hand, untoiled for, endowed with all delights and conforming to every taste.
For this blessed is the earth, revealing your sweetness toward your children, and serving the desire of him who received it, was blended to whatever flavor each one wished.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, We worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, Holy Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in this wondrous sacrament you left us, as a memorial of the passion and death of your Son, Jesus, may we, who so reverence his body and blood, perceive within ourselves the effects of his redemption. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty God and most gracious Father, you gave us parents for the rearing of each new generation and the fulfillment of your purposes here on earth. You poured into their hearts the graces of faith, love, and sacrifice. So on this Father's Day, dedicated to the honor of our fathers, we ask you to bless all the fathers of our congregation, both living and deceased. Empower them to lovingly fulfill the obligations that you have set before them as they look to the example of Saint Joseph. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated. On this, the Sunday in the octave of the most holy body and blood of Christ, we take the first reading from the book of Genesis. In those days, Melchizedek, king of Salem, brought out bread and wine, and being a priest of the Most High, he blessed Abram with these words, "Blessed be Abram by God Most High, the creator of heaven and earth, and blessed be God Most High, who delivered your foes into your hand." Then Abram gave him a tenth of everything. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, they all look to you to give them food in due time.
When you give it to them, they gather it. When you hold in your hand, they are filled with good things.
The second reading is prescribed by the church for today. It's taken from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night he was handed over, took bread, and after he had given thanks, broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way also the cup after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord, the death of the Lord, till he comes. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The sequence for today. Laud, O Zion, your salvation, laud with hymns of exaltation, Christ your King and Shepherd true. Bring him all the praise you know. He is more than you bestow. Never can you reach his due. Special theme for glad Thanksgiving is the quickening and the living, bread today before you set. From his hands of old partaken, as we know of by faith unshaken, were the 12 at supper met. Full and clear ring out your chanting, joy your near, sweetest grace be wanting, from your heart let praises burst. For today the feast is holden, when the institution olden of that supper was rehearsed. Here the new law's new oblation by the king's revelation ends the form of ancient rite. Now the new, the old effaces, truth away the shadow chases, light dispels the gloom of night. What he did at supper seated, Christ ordained to be repeated, his memorial never to cease. And his rule for guidance, taking bread and wine, we hallow, making thus our sacrifice of peace. This the truth each Christian learns, bread into his flesh he turns, to his precious blood the wine. Sight has failed, nor thought conceives, what a dauntless faith believes, resting on a power divine. Here beneath these signs are hidden, priceless things to sense forbidden. Signs, not things, are all we see. Blood is poured and flesh is broken, yet in either wondrous token Christ entire we know to be. Whoso of this food partakes does not rend the Lord nor breaks. Christ is whole to all that taste. Thousands are as one receivers, one as thousands of believers, eats of him who cannot waste. Bad and good the feast are sharing of what diver dooms preparing, endless death or endless life. Life to these, to those damnation, see how like participation is with unlike issues rife. When the sacrament is broken, doubt not, but believe 'tis spoken, that each severed outward token does the very whole contain. Not the precious gift divides, breaking, but the sign betides. Jesus still the same abides, still unbroken does remain. Lo, the angel's food is given to the pilgrim who has striven. See the children's bread from heaven, which on dogs may not be spent. Truth, the ancient types fulfilling, Isaac bound, a victim willing, Paschal lamb, its lifeblood spilling, manna to the Father's sent. Very bread, good shepherd, tend us. Jesu, of your love befriend us. You refresh us, you defend us. Your eternal goodness send us in the land of life to see. You who all things can and know, who on earth such food bestows, grant us with your saints the lowest, where the heavenly feast you show, fellow heirs and guests to be. Amen. Alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Almighty and eternal God, who cleansed the lips of the prophet Isaiah with a burning coal, cleanse my heart and my lips through your gracious mercy, that I may worthily proclaim your holy gospel. Through Christ our Lord, amen. May the Lord be in my heart and on my lips, that I may worthily proclaim his holy gospel. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory be to you, Lord.
Jesus spoke to the crowds about the kingdom of God, and he healed those who needed to be cured. As the day was drawing to a close, the 12 approached him and said, "Dismiss the crowd so that they can go to the surrounding villages and farms and find lodging and provisions, for we are in a deserted place here." He said to them, "Give them some food yourselves." They replied, "Five loaves and two fish are all we have, unless we ourselves go and buy food for all these people." Now the men there numbered about 5,000. Then he said to his disciples, "Have them sit down in groups of about 50. They did so and made them all sit down. Then taking the five loaves and the two fish and looking up to heaven, he said the blessing over them, broke them, and gave them to the disciples to set before the crowd. They all ate and were satisfied. And when the leftover fragments were picked up, they filled 12 wicker baskets." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Continue in my love. Words taken from the Gospel according to St. John. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. To you, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ, today, we celebrate the Sunday and the octave of Corpus Christi. There are only two times in which we read a sequence, as in today we offered in the octave of Corpus Christi. The only other sequence that we read is at Pentecost. And so when we think of a sequence that was written many, many centuries ago, we think of the importance of those two solemnities. The first solemnity was when the Holy Spirit descended upon those who were gathered in the upper room. And on Corpus Christi, we are reminded of the power, and most importantly, the internal gift that our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ gave to not only his disciples at the Last Supper, but he intended for all of us as Eucharistic people to receive. Those who have a Holy Bible, who take the time to read the Word of God, I direct you to the 6th chapter of the Gospel according to St. John. It is what I call the bread chapter. For in that 6th chapter, Jesus gives a great exposition on bread. "I am the living bread which has come down from heaven, and if anyone eats this bread, He shall live forever, for the bread which I shall give for the life of the world is my flesh. Isn't it interesting that today in the octave of Corpus Christi, we do not read about the institution of the Blessed Sacrament, but we read about a time in which Jesus had close to 5,000 that came to listen to the Word of God. Afterward, of course, we don't know how long the discourse of Jesus, but it could be assured that people who traveled many, many miles to hear the Word of God preached by Jesus were hungry. And so the Lord called on his disciples and he says, give them something to eat. And in reality, what did the apostles say? 5 loaves and 2 fish are not enough. It was probably just enough for the disciples and for Jesus. This is the second time where it is recorded in Holy Scripture that Jesus fed the masses. Today it was 5,000. Another time it was 4,000. And in each time, what did Jesus do before distributing? He blessed the gifts unto God. And as it turned out, in both instances, we read that there were 12 wicker baskets that were filled. One of the things that I can say when we deal with the Holy Eucharist, which in the year of 2022 the church has set aside in the future direction, the importance of the Holy Eucharist. Just as we gather in the upper room, as the apostles did at that Last Supper, just as they centered around the table of the Lord, which we do whenever we come to Holy Mass, we take that bread and that wine, which was a part of the Passover, and where Jesus now gave a new covenant. The bread which represented the unleavened bread, which took place at the Exodus when the children of Israel came out of Egypt. Jesus said, it is not Moses who gave you this bread, but my Father who is in heaven. It is what we know as the manna. And for the 40 years in which the children of Israel wandered through the wilderness, God provided. The children of Israel constantly complained after coming out of Egypt, we don't have any food. We don't have any water. So when we read in Holy Scripture that Moses took his staff and he struck a rock and water began to flow. And when they complained that they had no food, what did God do? He gave them manna every single day. Now there weren't 10 people. They were not 100 people. But according to Scripture, they were thousands, tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands. But yet God provided. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, one of the things that we talk about today is the importance of the Eucharist, and the central message is that God provides. But we need to turn to God as the great provider. How many of you, when you sit down at meal, take a moment and say, thank you, God, for this meal? And how many of you say, there are so many less fortunate that have less food than I have? You know, we take things for granted. But the fact remains is that if we, people of the faith, look to God as the provider, then we will be filled. This is his promise. This is what Christ promised on that night in which he was betrayed. He took bread. He said, "This is my body." He took the wine and he said, "This is my blood, which is going to be poured out for you." The apostles had left Jesus. They didn't witness what took place on Calvary Hill. But John, the youngest, the one that we call the beloved, he witnessed. And he later talked about it. And he later taught about it. That God is the provider of our needs. And so we come to church, not only to have fellowship with one another, but most importantly to come before the altar of God and to affirm that God is our provider. In good times and in bad. And that we are given an invitation by our Lord to come and to partake of the body and blood of Christ. Yesterday, I had the opportunity of officiating a 50th wedding anniversary. The church was packed. Wayne and I witnessed that there were many, many people of different faiths who came and received the body and blood of Christ. And so, my brothers and sisters, being Eucharistic people, never take God for granted. Always give God his due thanks. The other thing that I just wanted to mention for a few seconds is that today is Father's Day. It is a day in which we remember our fathers. It is only right and fitting. In doing some of the research and looking in and preparing a short homily on some of the facts, that Father's Day is so many times overlooked. And reading that, it is estimated that there is $17 billion nowadays that is spent on Father's Day. During the Depression, back in the 30s, the retailers tried to come up with a scheme so that they could make money by having a day set aside for fathers. When we take $17 billion nowadays for gifts that are given to our fathers, it is paled to what is spent on Mother's Day. Approximately $32 billion on Mother's Day versus Father's Day. The fact remains is that, as somebody once said, and it is true, we have but one father, and we have but one mother. And in the Old Testament, what was one of the laws that Moses carried down from Mount Sinai? Honor your father and your mother. Though being a father is very, very difficult, especially nowadays, the fact remains is that in many, many countries, Father's Day is celebrated in a different way. It is not celebrated in June, but rather on March 19th. And what is March 19th in the church? Saint Joseph, the worker. And he sets the standard for all fathers and for all men. The principles of love, support, comfort, and as a provider. And so today, as we remember our fathers in prayer, both living and deceased, we look to Saint Joseph. And most importantly, the lessons that Saint Joseph shared with his Son Jesus. We understand the greater relationship that Jesus had with his Heavenly Father, and which we all have with our Heavenly Father. As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Continue in my love. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. May the name of Jesus Christ be praised, now and forevermore. Amen. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven by the power of the Holy Spirit, who was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in fulfillment of the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father. With the Father and the Son he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Just as the living Father sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. Please be seated. Thank you. brothers and sisters, that our gifts of love and sacrifice may truly be accepted this day by God, our Heavenly Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice in your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the benefit of this holy church.
Amen. Let us pray. Gracious God, grant your church unity in Christ and peace with you. May we who present these gifts to you live according to the spirit of the gospel and come to know eternal life. We ask this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us pray, Almighty God, as we offer these gifts. Help us to honor our fathers, that our days may be long in the land which you have given us. We ask all of this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your poor hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto the Lord our God. Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. At the Last Supper, as he sat with table with his apostles, he offered himself to you as the spotless lamb and the acceptable gifts that gives you perfect and holy praise. Christ has given us this memorial of his passion to bring to us his saving powers. When we receive the bread of heaven, we are nourished and strengthened by our Lord to live in holiness and righteousness before our Heavenly Father. We now come to your table to be fed with this wonderful sacrament and grow in the likeness of the risen Christ. Therefore, we join this day with the angels and archangels, with all the saints and the entire church, and we lift our hymn of praise to your glory, repeating very humbly,
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Most merciful Father, we most humbly pray and ask you through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, to accept us and to bless these gifts, these presents, these holy and spotless sacrifices, which we offer to you in the first place for your holy Catholic Church, that you would guide it in peace, defense, and unity throughout the whole world with its bishops and priests, especially Anthony, our Prime Bishop, and Paul, our Bishop, and all who profess the true Orthodox and Catholic faith which comes to us from the Apostles. Remember your servants, O Lord. My brothers and sisters, let us pray for the sick, the suffering and the dying, the hungry, the homeless, and the unemployed. Let us pray for all those suffering from the coronavirus and pray for them and their families. May we give thanks for the blessings of doctors, nurses, first responders, and healthcare workers. In our deepest prayers, let us pray for all abused and neglected children, as well as all abused and neglected animals, and all victims of violence, both here and abroad. Let us pray to Almighty God that he would send forth his blessings upon those who serve in our armed forces, that his holy angels may watch over, protect, and return all of them back to their families. And may we also offer our prayers and thanksgivings for all who are present here, whose faith and devotion are known to you, for whom we offer or who offer up to you the sacrifice of praise for themselves and all their own, for the hope of salvation and deliverance, and who freely choose to serve you, the living, eternal, and true God. We join in communion with and honor above all others the memory of Mary, the glorious Virgin Mother of our Lord and God Jesus Christ. Also your blessed apostles, martyrs, and confessors, together with all the countless number of saintly men and women of all nations, but especially of our nation, who lived, suffered, and died for the glory of your name and the coming of your kingdom. May the remembrance of these praiseworthy people encourage us to follow their heroic example, making us worthy of your grace and love, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We ask you, Lord, to graciously accept our offering of that of your whole family, and so order our days in your peace, that we may be saved from spiritual damnation and counted among the flock of your chosen people, through Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, we ask you to bless, to confirm, to accept, and make it pleasing unto yourself, so that it may be filled with the power of the Holy Spirit and become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. The day before his suffering and death, in order to manifest his infinite love to his disciples, and through them to all who would believe in him, to fill the hearts of his followers with the fire of this love, draw them to himself, make them joyful, and save them, he instituted these holy mysteries, in which spiritually and bodily, in his entire being, he again lives among his people. At that solemn moment, so sacred for the whole human family, our Savior took bread into his holy and venerable hands, and having lifted his eyes to heaven, to you, God, his almighty Father, and giving thanks to you, he blessed it, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which is given for you." In like manner, after supper, taking this excellent chalice into his holy and venerable hands, again giving thanks to you, he blessed it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which shall be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. As often as you do this, do it in remembrance of me." Therefore, in remembrance of this Christ, your Son, our Lord, in his blessed passion, resurrection, and his glorious ascension, we, your servants and faithful people, offer to you, to your divine majesty, from your own gifts and presents, a pure offering, a holy offering, an immaculate offering, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to regard these offerings with favor and joy, and accept them as you receive the gifts of your just servant Abel, the sacrifice of our patriarch Abraham, and that which your high priest Melchizedek offered you, a holy sacrifice in the Immaculate Host. We humbly ask you, Almighty God, command that this offering be brought by the hands of your holy angel to your high altar, into the presence of your divine majesty, that we, who receive the most sacred body and blood of your Son from this altar, may be filled with every blessing and grace, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, remember your servants, especially all our fathers, who have gone before us with the sign of faith, and who now sleep in peace. To these souls, Lord, and all who rest in Christ, grant, we pray, a place of refreshment, light, and peace, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. And grant us, your sinful servants, who hope in the greatness of your mercy, some part in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, and all your saints who shed their blood for your name. Their hearts were always open to justice and mercy, and with lives patterned after their divine master, merited eternal joy. Number us in their company, Lord, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. By whom you always create, sanctify, revive, bless and freely give us all these good things. Through him, with him, in him. All honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, in the unity with the Holy Spirit. Forever and ever. Let us pray, instructed by our Savior's teaching, and following divine example, we say with confidence, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done. As it is in heaven, give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Now can we deliver us, Lord, from all evils, past, present, and future, and by the intercession of the blessed and glorious Mother of God, Mary, together with your blessed apostles, Peter and Paul, also Andrew and all the saints, grant us peace in our day, that being supported by the help of your mercy, we may be free from sin and secure from all disturbance, through the same Jesus Christ, your Son and our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, forever and ever. May the peace of the Lord be with you always. May this commingling and consecration of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ help us who receive it to everlasting life. Amen. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Do not look at our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, for you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, by the will of the Father and the work of the Holy Spirit, your death brought life to the world. By your holy body and blood, free me from all my sins and from every evil. Keep me faithful to your teaching and never let me be parted from you, who lives and reigns God forever and ever. Amen. May the partaking of your body and blood, Lord Jesus, not be cause for my judgment or condemnation. Though I am unworthy to receive this great sacrament, through your loving kindness may become my safeguard and healing remedy. Our saving Master, awaken in all of us living faith, fervent love, worship, adoration, and holy longing. Through this communion, make us your willing servants, zealous to fulfill your holy will. May it at last unite us entirely with you, our Lord and our God. Grant us who lives and reigns with God the Father in unity with the Holy Spirit forever and ever. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, for those of you who will not be receiving sacramentally the body and blood of Christ, I ask at this time that you recite along with me the act of spiritual communion. Most loving Jesus, I adore you in the most blessed sacrament in which you are truly present. I love you above all things and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, I ask you to come spiritually into my heart and heal my soul. I embrace you and unite myself with you. May I never be separated from you. Inflame my heart with the fire of your love, my Lord and Savior. Amen. I will take the bread of heaven, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. May the body of our Lord Jesus Christ preserve my soul unto life everlasting. Amen. What shall I return unto the Lord for all the graces he hath rendered unto me? I will take the chalice of salvation, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. With high praise will I call upon him, and I shall be safe from all my enemies. May the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ preserve my soul unto life everlasting. Amen. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Lord,
I am not to receive you, but who says the word, and I shall be healed.
Receive me.
Thank you.
This is the bread that came down from heaven. Unlike your ancestors who ate and still died, whoever eats this bread will live forever. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, may the sacrament of the altar, the pledge of your love for us, move us to long for eternal happiness. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit and art one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty God, give us grateful hearts for the blessings of fatherhood, strengthened by this Holy Eucharist, inspire us to understand and appreciate of Father's spirit of love and self-denial. Through the incarnation of your Son, you showed us the love a father has for his children and the way to truth, life, and understanding. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Go, the sacrifice is offered.
Praise be to God.
May the tribute of our worship be pleasing to you, most holy Trinity. Grant that the sacrifice which I, though unworthy, have offered up into the sight of your majesty be acceptable to you. Through your mercy may be effective for myself and all those for whom I have offered it, through Christ our Lord. Amen. May the Almighty and merciful God bless you. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. In the beginning was the Word was in God's presence, and the Word was God. He was present to God in the beginning. Through him all things came into being, and apart from him nothing came to be. Whatever came to be in him found the life of the light of men. The light shines on in the darkness, a darkness that did not overcome it. There was a man named John sent by God who came as a witness to testify to the light, so that through him all might believe, but only to testify to the light, for he himself was not the light. The real light which gives light to every man was coming into the world. He was in the world, and through him the world was made, yet the world did not know who he was. To his own he came, yet his own did not accept him. Any who did accept him, he empowered to become children of God. These are they who believe in his name, who are begotten not by blood, nor by carnal desire, nor by man's willing it, but by God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory of an only Son coming from the Father, filled with enduring love.
Thanks be to God.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. And for the repose of the souls of all our faithful departed fathers, as well as for the repose of the souls of all our faithful. Eternal rest grant unto their souls, O Lord. May they all rest in peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.